All of us have received invitations to special events, celebrations, or gatherings. Sometimes we're delighted. Other times we may look for an excuse not to attend. When we send out an invitation, we hope that everyone will accept our offer of hospitality, and we're disappointed when we're turned down. The bread is his body, the wine is the blood. Jesus has prepared a feast for us that is foreshadowed in the communion table. All are welcome, but many never receive the free gift. Whether it's because they haven't heard or don't believe that it's for them, we have the privilege of asking them to join us. The table is ready. Who will come? He's dying tomorrow. So, Cortana, we're going to be talking today about the feast is ready. Now, why do you think you got that plate?
Because, if mine is a feast, it's like what we would eat on, that it looks pretty. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And, like, for a wedding, you would have it.
Okay. A wedding? What other special occasions might you have?
Like birthday, like special birthdays.
Okay. So, this is going to help us think about our lesson for today. Now, you brought this picture or this writing. Can you read that for us?
Hope, my gift to baby Jesus from Cortana. Hope to all kids. Open my heart to people. Peace to all countries. Everyone needs an open heart.
Nice.
And then, my gift to baby Jesus from Cortana. God. Good for the world. Our Savior Jesus died for us.
Beautiful. Now, can you just explain this here?
What That's like do? A cross, okay. But I added a lot of color.
Oh, I see the cross here. And it's almost like a stained glass, isn't it?
Yeah.
You did put some thought and time in here, didn't you? And the globe? I like that. And over here, this is the sign for?
Peace.
Peace sign. And the heart, the love. And it spells hope. Very neat. So hope, open, peace, everyone. Well, that fits really well with what we're going to be talking about. So in the Bible, it talks about a king is having a wedding feast. I have a picture here. Now, doesn't that look festive? Don't you just want to sit there?
And it has, like, all of the names on the black thing.
Yeah, there's a name for everyone. The problem that the king had was he had names for everyone, but they gave excuses. I can't come. I'm sorry, I won't be there. Have you ever had a party or something special where you invited someone and they couldn't come?
Yeah.
So how did you feel?
I felt really sad because it was like one of my best friends.
Mm-hmm. It's disappointing, isn't it? And you put so much time and effort into it. How do you think the king would feel if he came that day and there wasn't one person sitting at the table?
He would probably feel like mad and sad in the middle.
So what did he do instead? What would your solution be when you have a whole table ready, you've prepared the meal, and nobody shows up?
Invite different people.
Invite different people. And you would be in a hurry, wouldn't you? Because what happens to the food if you just leave it too long?
It might get spoiled.
So you've got to get people there fast, right? The only problem is that if you end up going out on the street and you've got to get people fast, what kind of people might you get?
Homeless people, mean people.
Mm-hmm. So why do you think Jesus told that story about the kingdom of heaven?
Like, if he made a perfect table, like, Jesus would make this story, so then people would, like, if they had this, they would understand the story.
Yeah, and what would the story be? Who does Jesus invite to his table, to his kingdom?
He invites heaven and angels.
That's right. He invites us too, right? Mm-hmm. Like, Jesus wants us to come to the table. In your poem, you said, open my heart to people, peace to all countries. Everyone needs an open heart. And that's the message that Jesus gives. Mm-hmm.
But it also means that when we come to the table, there might be some people sitting beside us mm-hmm. that we don't even know, or that wouldn't be our best friends or our first choice. So sometimes that makes us uncomfortable, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But we've all been invited, so we have to learn how to get along and accept the people who are by us.
I was thinking about the common cup, and I was thinking about that because of some of the items I have on our memory wall here. Some of you know we lived in Yellowknife, and so my dad traveled around, and he brought back items from all over the north. And you can see some of them here. There's a little item there that he brought back. He met a lot of Inuit in his journeys, and often he would purchase little gifts to bring home. But it reminded me of being in Yellowknife. And when we lived up there, we went to a small little church called Holy Family Lutheran Church. And we had a pastor by the name of Caesar Hine, and he was a pastor and he was a doctor. And he was a wonderful, wonderful man. Because he had clients in his practice, we would often find his clients at church on Sunday morning. Now, some of the clients that Pastor Hine had were, well, I should say, quite interesting in character. In fact, he would go down Sunday morning early and pick up a few of those in what was known as Old Town. Yes, he would pick them up and he would bring them, usually bachelors, two or three, and he would bring them to church. And we would be sitting in the chairs because it was our school, the church was in a school, and he would bring them in and we would go, oh my word, what did he bring in here to church? Often the odor was the most visible thing in my mind right now. I can smell the odor, and it wasn't just the dirty clothes, it was the reek of alcohol. Caesar picked them up somewhere, not sure where, in what condition they were, and brought them to church. And we would go through worship, and then we would get to communion. Yes, the feast is ready. We're coming to the Lord's table to receive his body and blood, the grace and the love and the forgiveness of Jesus. I have to admit that there were many people who wanted to get there first for communion because we only had the common cup. There was no individual classes. It was just the common cup. And I remember a couple of times people rushing up to the front of the line because sometimes these gentlemen were in the front row. They wanted to get ahead of them. Now, in one instance, you can kind of understand a little bit the concern because some of these men, there was snot running down their noses from the cold, from the evening before, and you didn't know where it would drip. I'm just telling the truth. That was what it was like. And so we would take communion together. And that story has always been so powerful for me because thinking back on it, the pastor brought people where they were at to come to the feast, and to share that with one another. It doesn't matter where they were, who they were, where they'd been, all could come to enjoy the feast that was ready. As we think about Advent, we're coming to meet the child who's Jesus, who will become that great peace for us when he gives his life for us upon the cross.
A reading from Matthew chapter 22. Jesus spoke to them again in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven is like a king who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. He sent his servants to those who had been invited to the banquet to tell them to come, but they refused to come. Then he sent some more servants and said, 'Tell those who have been invited that I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and fatted cattle have been butchered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet.' But they paid no attention and went off, one to his field, another to his business. The rest seized his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged." Then he said to his servants, "The wedding banquet is ready, but those I invited did not deserve to come. So go to the street corners and invite to the banquet anyone you find." So the servants went out into the streets and gathered all the people they could find, the bad as well as the good, and the wedding hall was filled with guests.
Let us pray together. Lord God, we thank you for your love for us. We thank you, God, for the meal that you've prepared for us. We thank you, God, that we can come to your table as we are. And Lord, we pray that whoever comes to this table, we would come with them, alongside them, because your body and blood is broken, shed for all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.